Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, sent in by Allie. Allie sent this in via YouTube. She has a chart that currently is showing some data. When she types new data to the right of her data, it would like the chart to automatically extend. Now, I'm going to talk about how to use a dynamic named range to solve this today, and tomorrow we'll take a look at an easier way to do it, particularly if you're in Excel 2003 or in Excel 2007. You're going to notice today I'm back in Excel 2003. I swore I wouldn't do this, but I've tried this trick now several times in Excel 2007, and it is not working. It's working in Excel 2003. So let's show how it works, and then if you're in Excel 2007, you can use the new method tomorrow. Dynamic named range is a named range that generally uses the offset function. The offset function, hard to understand, amazing function. It can take up to 5 arguments. You specify what the starting cell is. It always has to have an anchor cell. So in this case, we're going to create a dynamic named range that refers to this yellow range right here, but will grow as we add new items to the right-hand side. So of course, the starting cell is B2, and I want to lock that down. So the starting range is going to be sheet 1, exclamation, dollar sign B, dollar sign 2. The number of rows down, they give you an opportunity to say, hey, from that starting cell, we want to go some number of rows down. In this case, it's 0. And some number of rows to the right, well, in this case, again, that's 0. They let you specify how tall the range is going to be. Well, it's only 1 row tall. But the width, now this is the thing that's going to change every time. As we add new data to the right-hand side, the width is going to get wider and wider and wider. So I'm going to use a formula here, equal count of sheet 1, exclamation, dollar sign 2, colon, dollar sign 2. Let's just see how that works. See, right now it says that there are 6 numbers in this range. If we type a new number out here, that formula updates to show 7 numbers in that range. So let me undo that. And here I'm going to change this back to just text, put an apostrophe before it. So these are kind of my notes here. I always have trouble with these dynamic named ranges. I like to plan them out before I even start. We're going to define a second range for the chart labels. And that is pretty cool because that's going to be chart data is the starting point. Number of rows down, minus 1. In other words, 1 row above our data set. Number of columns to the right, 0. And we're not going to specify anything for the height and width to make it be the same height and width as chart labels. All right, so now we're ready to do insert name define. So we come up here to insert name define and chart data. So this is going to be sheet 1, exclamation chart data. It refers to equal offset. And I'm going to press the F2 key here. Right now I'm in enter mode. If I would try and use the N key or any of the arrow keys, it would start inserting cell addresses. I press F2, you'll see down here it says enter mode. Press F2, it gets into edit mode. That allows me to move right and left in here. So we start out from dollar sign B, dollar sign 2 is our starting cell. I have notes over here that show me that I want to put in a 0, comma, 0, comma, 1. And then finally, count of sheet 1. Exclamation, dollar sign 2, colon, dollar sign 2. Close the parenthesis for the count, close the parenthesis for the offset, and add that name. All right, now the next name that we're going to have is sheet 1, exclamation, chart labels. And this is going to be an offset function of sheet 1 chart data, comma, minus 1 that says go 1 row up from there. Comma 0. Click add. So we have our 2 dynamic named ranges now. Click OK. We're going to go into the chart, save the workbook before you do this. There's 4 elements here. The first one is the label for the series. We're not going to change that. The next one is the labels. So here where it says B1 to G1, we're going to say type our named range there, sheet 1 of chart labels. And then here where it has the data B2 to G2. Type our named range of chart data. Make sure everything looks okay. We press enter and the line stays there. That's great. Now, here's the cool thing. Here's how this works. When we come back next week and we type week 7, nothing changes. But as soon as we put a number in here, with 150, you watch the chart, it automatically updates. Very cool, isn't it? All right, so there you have it, a dynamic named range. This is the way people have been solving this problem for a long time. Now, in Excel 2003 and Excel 2007, there's easier ways to go. We'll take a look at that Maybe you can just avoid the whole offset function and get the same result. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.